my goodness. I think I'm gonna have to leave sound on in this video because my 9-year-old is stuck on Daniel Tiger mode. And she does not have COVID. Oh gosh. It is ragweed season. So, there you go. I need to just leave those there. When doing the peekaboo, it's always really helpful to have a very good coverage of your chunky glitter to show through. And I just keep it on that top 1/3 or so of my nail. And there's the glitter sticking up, so I'm just gonna trim it so that I don't have a big blob of glitter. So next, I'm going to come in with my solid, and I'm going to take my base, I don't know, about yay high. So you can see I'm leaving a space between my cuticle and the base. And I'm hoping this turns out. I've only done it one other time, so I'm by no means an expert. Kids are fun. Oh gosh. So, and then you're just gonna kind of ombre it over. I don't know. Seems right. She's cleaning her room, by the way. There's a baby monitor that she doesn't know is on. I have no idea how well that sound is coming through on the video. I'm hoping it's good. Because it's cracking me up. Alright, I'm gonna move this out of the way. I was going to do that and then I didn't. Actually, yeah, I'm good. I have a bad habit of not being in the screen of my videos. I'm gonna dust that. I'm just gonna stay on the thumb. It's fine. And I'm gonna come down actually just a little bit further. I think. Yeah. So I don't know if you can tell the angle. You can see like it's obviously really thick at the cuticle and not so much at the bottom. So I feel like once I file and shape, I can really get that effect well. I know it's probably hard to see on the video, but I can see it. I promise you that it's there. And then ombre that over. I don't know if it's technically an ombre, but brush it on. And I guess it's kind of close to an ombre-ish. When I stick it in there, I'm just trying to make sure that I have a good coverage on the tip of my nail. I use peel base, and I use it over my whole nail, basically. I don't know why I'm cleaning up my cuticles, there's nothing there. Anyway, that's what holds the color on, that's what holds my nail on. This part. I'm actually gonna come in. I've got like a weird concave piece right here, and that's where I actually need it to not be concave. That's I do the apex method, and so that part of my nail, which is where my free edge begins, that's sort of your weakest point. I'm actually gonna pull that liquid up just a hair, and I'm just gonna scooch it so that it's thinner, and I may try to even kind of scoocher. There we go. Anyway, apex. sort of like an arch of a bridge, you know, the arch is the strongest point, so I want that a little thicker. Now that would be an ombre. As you can see, I didn't take the powder all the way up to the wet liquid. I did that intentionally because the Peekaboo glitter is essentially an ombre. It's just backwards of your typical glitter ombre. It's like a reversed version. There we go. That's a little better. So now I'm going to come over with my clear. And I tend to do pretty thick when I do clear. I have better success with like it not being cloudy and bubbly and weird when I do a thick one. I don't. Do what works for you is what I would say on that, but this is what works for me. So I'm gonna do that and dip her in the clear. Now if I'm I'm putting clear directly over glitters, I almost never dip directly into the clear, otherwise you'll end up with glitters. I use like a little pipette or a brush or something to pour it over, but since my clear was already encapsulated, I went ahead and did that. Okay, I'm gonna let that dry a minute. This next nail while that dries. I think I'm gonna do another layer of clear. Actually, I am not going to do another. Just kidding. I am going to go ahead and activate that because I have a limited battery and I want to show you how to do this particular nail. Okay. So while that dries, I'm going to go on to the next nail. Making sure, sometimes I miss my sidewall, so I have to consciously think, check your sidewall so you don't have holes. Like there. And you can see I'm actually kind of messy with my liquids. I don't know. I get it on my skin. I do try really hard not to get it on the cuticles because then I do run into issues with lifting. But I work really hard to file it off before I'm finished with my mani. So I don't know, it works for me. And I'm just holding it up at an angle and tapping that and letting the powder fall. I'm gonna come in over here where I put it on so thick. I had had a hole over there where I did not have any powder, so that is what I was doing. Okay, I actually feel pretty good about that one. So I'm going to encapsulate it and I'm encapsulating the whole nail at this point. Most of, well, I don't know the most of, some of the cuticle, like some of this area, will get filed off. And that's okay. Okay, so now I'm going to come back. I kind of want to move this out of the way. And that's not the one that's activated. And I'm going to shape it all up. And in the process of shaping, I will start to really kind of clear off some of the opaque powder off of the glitter that's there. Leaving that peekaboo effect. I still don't have quite the apex I'm looking for, that's why I'm filing quite a bit, because I want my apex. There we go, now we're getting it. So this is a pretty opaque solid, and you'll see that when I show you the finished product. I said finished project. I guess that would work too. I think some people tend to use more sheer colors. Just occurred to me I did not do a stiff brush on that, so hopefully I don't have weird bubbles and stuff. I think it'll look. We'll see. So you can see this white patch, that's actually, I've gone through the clear and I'm now into like the actual color. That should go away when I activate. I've never had it not, but I'm also doing this on video, so you never know what's going to happen. It's kind of Murphy's Law. When you want something to be perfect and done well, don't record it. Or anything that goes wrong can go wrong, right? When you're pressed. Anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and activate that to show you that finished effect. Oh look, see? It went away. There you have it. I have a feeling that this one actually will turn out even better. Just a hunch. I did a little better on my own reaction. I don't know. And that's the thing. Sometimes you mess up, or sometimes it just doesn't go the way you want it to go. And it's okay. It's all okay. And if you're a beginner watching this and you're feeling intimidated by some of these designs, I would just encourage you to try it. I mean, what do you have to lose? If it looks bad, it looks bad. And you wear it for a week or however long you wear them, and then you change it and do something different. It's fine. It's all good. And the more you try things and stretch your skills, the better you will get. And you learn kind of what works best for you. Yeah, this one isn't going to be as good, I don't think, actually. Maybe it will be. I don't know. I think I took too much of the color off. But we'll see. Let me jump. Don't say anything silly. I'm recording this. Way too much. I might have to go back over and fix this one. That's the other thing you can always do is go back and repair. I'm going to activate and see what it looks like, but I'm pretty sure I need to actually look. It turned out. So lesson learned there. I'm going to actually buff a little more right there. Activate to see what the final effect will be. There you go.